Please observe. Interesting, gentlemen. A one-cell creature resembling, more than anything else, a huge individual brain cell.
Yes, that would answer a lot of questions, wouldn't it?
Do you understand what I'm suggesting, Captain?
I think so. This may be one cell in a larger organism, an incredibly huge organism, in fact.
And although it is not physically connected to the other cells, it is nevertheless part of the whole creature, guided by the whole, drawing its strength from the whole, which probably accounts for its unusual resistance to our phaser weapons.
Existing so differently from any living matter or energy as we know it, that it may have come here, planet by planet, from an entirely different galaxy.
From a place where our physical laws do not apply. We may therefore find it difficult to destroy, Captain.
But not impossible, Mr. Spock. The Denevan that flew into the sun cried out that he was free, that he had won. That's the angle to work on, gentlemen. I want an analysis of all this from medical and life science departments within the hour.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, Captain. I've tried everything I can. Varian radiation, intense heat, even as great as 9,000 degrees.
And you're wasting your time. It has to be something that will kill the creature without destroying the human host.
Which happens to be my point. The thing won't die. Even at temperatures and radiation, which would burn Spock and your nephew to ashes.
I can't accept that, Bones.
We've got 14 science labs aboard this ship. The finest equipment and computers in the galaxy.
Captain. I understand your concern, your affection for Spock. The fact that your nephew is the last survivor of your brother's family.
Oh, no, Bones. There's more than two lives at stake here. I cannot let it spread beyond this colony, even if it means destroying a million people down there.
Captain's log, stardate 3289.8. I am faced with the most difficult decision of my life. Unless we find a way to destroy the creatures without killing their human hosts, my command responsibilities will force me to kill over a million people. Gentlemen.
I regret I see no other choice for you, Captain. We already know this thing has destroyed three civilizations. Perhaps more.
Gentlemen, I want it stopped too. Not at the cost of destroying over a million people.
Including myself, Doctor. And Captain Kirk's young nephew. Understandably upsetting. But once it spreads past here, there are dozens of colonies beyond. And billions of people.
If killing five people saves 10, it's a bargain. Is that your simple logic, Mr. Spock?
I will accept neither of those alternatives, gentlemen. I cannot let this thing expand beyond this planet. Nor do I intend to kill a million or more people to stop it. I want another answer. I'm putting you gentlemen on the hot seat with me. I want that third alternative.